Item number, SCP-383. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. All samples of SCP-383 must be kept in standard airtight plastic containers, frozen into ice blocks, and stored in a locker kept at -5°C at all times. All samples of SCP-383 removed for testing must be handled with a minimum safety equipment of a face mask, latex gloves, and protective goggles. Optional if personnel already wear prescription glasses. Personnel are reminded to wash hands after handling SCP-383-related materials. All suspected and confirmed infections of SCP-383 will be treated with personnel, and anyone they have had direct contact within the frame of infection placed into quarantine for the duration of testing. A confirmed case of SCP-383 will result in personnel being placed under a week-long quarantine and placed on antivirals until testing reveals that SCP-383 is fully flushed from the system. Infected civilians are to be treated similarly and given a Class B amnestic and told that they are in quarantine for a highly virulent new strain of the flu, and the cause of the outbreak must be identified. All objects created by SCP-383 must be cataloged, along with the current state of the host. Hosts of SCP-383 will be given a high-nutrition IV drip, and unless Class D testing is in operation, hosts will be kept mildly sedated and in safe, hospitable situations. For obvious security reasons, SCP-383 may not be introduced to any other SCPs. Description. SCP-383 is a viral infection, first categorized as a variant of influenza. The initial symptoms of SCP-383 are similar to those of the common cold, ranging through a variety of aches and pains, sinus issues, sore throat, upset stomach, coughing and sneezing, and fatigue. It appears to only be capable of infecting human hosts, but has been observed to be carried by other animals, such as rats and pigeons. Similar to a common infection, SCP-383 will work its way through the human body naturally within a few days, or faster with routine antivirals. However, SCP-383 is also accompanied by extreme waves of nausea. Along with bringing up the contents of the host's stomach, SCP-383 appears to be capable of, through unknown means, producing random items. These items are always sized appropriately to the host's mouth, even if it appears infeasible for them to originate from the stomach, suggesting that these items are actually produced either in the mouth or throat. More often than not, these items are useful, individually, to the host. For example, a host inside of a locked room may regurgitate a key, or a lockpick set, or a crowbar to pry the door open. While the results are far from consistent, the only pattern shown is that SCP-383 always produces items of use to the host in one way or another. SCP-383 has even been observed to create living animals and complex mechanical devices. Although SCP-383 would seem to have great potential as a Foundation asset, it should be noted that these items do not spontaneously appear. Rather, they are created from biomass from the human body. Victims are prone to anemia, nutrition loss, bone damage, and severe weight loss depending upon the fashion of items produced. Items that contain substances not found often inside the human body are often replaced with similar substances or missing non-vital parts. Infections can also cause damage to the mouth and esophagus and a weakening of the immune system. Hosts have also been observed to have a risk of choking on any items produced from SCP-383. Hosts of SCP-383 also report some difficulty swallowing foods, and the relatively consistent nausea makes it difficult to consume or digest any foods or liquids, occasionally resulting in dehydration. Due to SCP-383's highly virulent nature, occasional mutations can occur, resulting in SCP-383 strains that cause the host to regurgitate unsafe items, or substances such as boiling hot liquids or knives that injure or kill the host. Other somewhat common SCP-383 strains include a similar effect to the parent virus, but manifesting its item creation abilities through fecal excretion instead. Extra risk may be taken to prevent further strains of SCP-383 from developing, as a strain capable of infecting non-human entities, or with an entirely fatal reaction, could prove disastrous. Outbreaks of SCP-383 outside the SCP facility have been observed and contained. See addendum for details. Addendum: awaiting declassification. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-382, Haunted Baby Carriage, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.